Now that we've found the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the second derivative operator for periodic functions, we're going to do the first derivative, or more precisely, minus I times the first derivative. Because we worked out previously that minus I times the first derivative is Hermitian. So the eigenvalues are real, the eigenvectors are orthogonal, and the eigenvectors give an orthogonal basis for the entire vector space. So let's go to. We want to solve minus I times the derivative of f is equal to lambda times f, where lambda is some real number. Well, that means the derivative of f must be I lambda times f, and that means that f must be go as e to the I lambda x. If we had just a derivative is lambda times f, we would have e to the lambda x. If we have I lambda, we have I lambda x. So our function is some arbitrary constant e to the I lambda x. And now we're applying periodic boundary conditions, which means that the value at 0 and at L have to be the same. Which means that if you plug in L, you have to get e to the I L x times c equals c. In other words, e to the I lambda x, sorry, e to the I lambda L has to be 1. But we know that if e to the I some this is cosine lambda L plus I sine lambda L. And that's 1 precisely when the cosine is 1 and the sine is 0. In other words, when lambda L is a multiple of 2 pi. So lambda L has to be a multiple of 2 pi, which means that lambda has to be a multiple of 2 pi over L. Okay? But the key thing to note here is, in this equation, nothing says that lambda has to be positive or negative. N can be any integer, not just positive integers, any integer. So we have this whole string of eigenvalues running from minus infinity to plus infinity, going by steps of 2 pi over L. Well, that's the eigenvalues. And we have our eigenfunctions. Our eigenfunctions are e to the I lambda t, e to the I lambda x. So that's e to the 2 pi I over L nx. Okay. And of course, that's a cosine plus I times a sine. And we've seen these functions before. We already saw cosine of 2 pi nx over L and sine of 2 pi nx over L when we were diagonalizing the second derivative. Here they come in a particular combination, cosine plus I sine. And if you look at the minus n eigenfunction, you get cosine minus I sine. That is to say, if the eigenfunction for minus 2 pi n over L is the same cosine minus the same sine. Cosine plus I sine has eigenvalue 2 pi n over L. Cosine minus I sine has eigenvalue minus 2 pi n over L. Now, remember, we saw the cosine and the sine as eigenfunctions of the second derivative. And that's not a coincidence, because if you take minus I times the first derivative and do it twice, you get minus the second derivative. In other words, p squared is minus a. So anything that's an eigenfunction of p is automatically an eigenfunction of a, with eigenvalue minus lambda squared. And sure enough, 2 pi n over L squared, or minus 2 pi n over L squared, gives you 4 pi squared n squared over L squared, and that's minus the eigenvalues of A. Okay. Now, these eigenfunctions of our operator P give a nice orthogonal basis for L2. So here are our eigenfunctions, e to the 2 pi I and x over L, where n is any integer, positive or negative. And you can check directly that they're orthogonal. The inner product of psi n with psi m is this integral. See, this you take e to the 2 pi I and x over L bar is e to the minus 2 pi I and x over L. You conjugate the I. And that's e to the 2 pi I m minus n x over L. And if m is different from n, you just do the integral and you get something which, when you apply it at the two endpoints, give you the same value. And so you get 0. If m is equal to n, it's e to the 0 dx, so that you're integrating 1 dx, and that gives you L. In other words, the inner product of any vector with itself gives you L. The inner product of any vector with a different eigenvector gives you 0, which is to say, we have an orthogonal basis for L2. In the next video, we'll see what happens when you decompose functions in this basis, and that's Fourier series.